How old is the Earth? I'm glad you asked. 4.6 billion years. Well, as human beings, we live what, 100 years? It's very difficult to digest 4.6 billion years. Geologists have come up with a way to make that 4.6 billion years somewhat more digestible, and that is by breaking it down into smaller units. Here are these four units. The largest unit we call eons. These are hundreds of millions of years to billions of years. Eons are then broken down into eras, which are tens of billions of years to hundreds of millions of years. Eras are broken down into periods, which are single-digit millions to tens of billions of years. And periods are broken down into epochs, which are tens of thousands of years to single-digit millions of years. In reality, this is not about the number of years. This is about great Earth events, life forming, life coming up out of the seas, gigantic objects hitting our planet and changing the biology of the planet, huge events tectonically, glaciers forming and covering large expanses of the planet, glaciers disappearing. That's really what happens when we switch from one of these things to another. But they do tend to line up in these numbers. I lifted these two diagrams from the internet. These are versions of the geologic timescale. If you take a look at them, the names are the same. However, the numbers are slightly different. In reality, when we're talking about hundreds of millions of years, what's the difference if we add or subtract a million years here or there? It's not much difference. But these are the general time frames. I'm going to show you the time frames that I want you to use, even though those are not perfect and certainly are not exact. If we knew everything about the planet and humans had been around from the very beginning, 4.6 billion years ago, which of course we have not. Here's the geologic timescale I would like you to use. The single largest block of time is called Precambrian time. This goes from 4.6 billion years ago to about 543 million years ago. During Precambrian time, there's some dispute as to whether there were two or three eons. What I can tell you about it is there is very little left. Our planet is, in a lot of ways, a kind of living thing because of the tectonic processes, the atmosphere, running water, all of these things. As a result of that, whatever would have been around then is overwhelmingly wiped out or rotted. However, most people agree life began towards the end of the Precambrian time. 4.6 billion years ago, what would have been happening was there would have been swirls of dust and gases going around the sun. And that material would bump into each other itself, accrete together, get larger as a result of that, gain gravity, and then act like a vacuum going around the sun, sucking in more and more material, making the planets bigger and bigger. I have a ceiling fan in my bedroom that during the summer goes almost constantly. When I stop it and I take a look at it after it's been running for 3 weeks, and I look at the front end of the blades, there's dust that has accumulated on the front end of the blades as the blades have swirled around the center of the fan. In a way, this is what happens with our planet. As it goes around the sun, material is accreted. Most of the material that's out there has already been accreted, but occasionally we get hit by something and we are accreting more material. Following Precambrian time, our planet entered into what's known as the Phanerozoic Eon. Zoic is one of the Greek words for life. So this is when life really begins to happen in a big way. It goes from 543 million years ago until now. So we are in the Phanerozoic Eon. The Phanerozoic Eon is broken into three eras. The Paleozoic Era. Paleo means old, so this means old life. The Paleozoic Era went from 543 million years ago to 248 million years ago. Life begins to come up out of the oceans onto land in a fairly substantial way during the Paleozoic. That's followed by the Mesozoic Era. Meso means middle, so this is middle life. This went from 248 million years ago to 65 billion years ago. Most people would say 66.5 million, but we're going to go with 65 million. This was the era of the dinosaurs. Of course, most dinosaurs, these gigantic beasts that roam the planet, were vegetarians. That would mean that to sustain themselves, there needed to be a lot of vegetation. Well, the continents were in different places then than they are now. They've moved. You know that centered on the equator is the equatorial low, a thermal pressure belt. You have warm rising air that creates clouds of precipitation. Of course, today, we have the major tropical rainforests here, the Amazon, the Congo, and in Indonesia. At that time, there would have been more land along the equator and more tropical rainforests. This would have been one of the things that fed these gigantic animals. This is also the era from which our fossil fuels, oil, coal, and natural gas, come from. They are derived from that vegetation overwhelmingly that would grow, die, grow, die, grow, die over hundreds of millions of years, be compressed, and then turned into the fossil fuels. This is why I said to you before, what we're doing is we're taking hundreds of millions of years of sequestered carbon that's in the planet that came out of the atmosphere from all this vegetation, and we're dumping it back into the atmosphere over 2.5 centuries. If we took hundreds of millions of years to dump it back in the atmosphere, everything would probably be fine. Then, around 65 million years ago, a large object comes flying out of space and strikes our planet right about where the Yucatan Peninsula is at today. Everything in that vicinity is killed off immediately. And in fact, even as far away as where Montana is at today, rocks as big as your house come raining down and kill things within about 18 hours of this strike. Lots of materials thrown up in the atmosphere that obscures the sun, which then begins to kill off the vegetation and kills off the dinosaurs. At the same time, they were smaller animals, slightly smarter, hairier. They had mammary glands, which allowed them to feed their young directly. Most of them did not lay eggs. They gave live birth. These were mammals. That ushered in the era of the mammal, which is the Cenozoic era or new life era. That goes from 65 billion years ago until now. So we are in the Cenozoic era, which is basically the era of the mammal. The Cenozoic era is broken into two periods. The tertiary period that goes from 65 billion years ago to 2.6 million years ago, and the quaternary period, which goes from 2.6 million years ago until now. So we are in the quaternary period, which is broken into two epochs. The Pleistocene epoch that goes from 2.6 million years ago to 10,000 years ago. This is what most people refer to as the Ice Age, although you'll see in the last section, I'll have more detail on this. But this is a time of extensive glacial advance interspersed with varying degrees of glacial retreat. Then the Holocene epoch, which is what we're in now, that has gone from 10,000 years ago, the end of the glacial times, to present. Some people argue that we are now entering into the Anthropocene. Anthro, of course, has to do with humans, because human beings are altering everything. The atmosphere, the oceans, the rivers, the lakes, the land, the soil, you name it. The vegetation, we're moving vegetation into places it was never at before. Moving animals into places they were never at before. So it's not impossible that we're in this new epoch called the Anthropocene. But this is more of an intellectual scientific discussion than it is reality at this point, at least.